an adverb can modify a verb, an adjective, another adverb, a phrase, or a clause. An adverb indicates manner, place, time, cause, or degree and answers questions such as how, when, where, how much. In the following examples, each of the highlighted words is an adverb. The seamstress quickly made the morning clothes. In this sentence, the adverb quickly modifies the verb made and indicates in what manner or how fast the clothing was constructed. The midwives waited patiently through a long labor. Similarly, in this sentence, the adverb patiently modifies the verb waited and describes the manner in which the midwives waited. The boldly spoken words would return to haunt the rebel. In this sentence, the adverb boldly modifies the adjective spoken. Adverbs of manner, how, adverbs of place, where, adverbs of time, when, adverbs of frequency, how often, adverbs of degree, to what extent, intensifiers, reveal attitudes. Focus of adverbs, focus attention. Viewpoint adverbs and connectives help us to present information in a coherent fashion. Sing loudly, walk briskly, jump high. Adverb of manner. An adverb used to show how an action is done is known as an adverb of manner. Quickly, bravely, happily, hard, fast, well, clearly, soundly, probably, evidently, unfortunately, luckily, sadly. Example, they lived happily. Madhvi walks gracefully. She speaks beautifully. Adverb of place. An adverb used to show where an action is done is known as an adverb of place. Example, here, there, up, down, near, below, above, away, out, in, everywhere, backward, within, by. I went there. She stood near the gate. Please come here. Adverb of time. An adverb used to show when an action is done is known as an adverb of time. Now, then, today, tomorrow, early, soon, still, yet, before, late, ago, lately, daily, already, never, since, formally. My father is not at home now. She will come here soon. She came late yesterday. Adverb of frequency. An adverb used to show how often an action is done is known as an adverb of frequency. Once, twice, often, never, always, occasionally, again, frequently, seldom, sometimes. Example, they talk to each other again. We visited Agra twice. They never go to films. Adverbs of frequency. Always, 100%, 90% usually, 80% frequently, 70% often, 50% sometimes, 30% occasionally, 10% seldom, 5% rarely, 0% never. I always go shopping after work. Adverb of certainty. An adverb used to show definiteness of the action is known as an adverb of certainty. Example, certainly, surely, definitely, obviously. Surely she loves me. I shall certainly help you. Ramaya is obviously very clever. Adverb of degree. An adverb used to show how much or in what degree or to what extent an action is done is known as an adverb of degree. Very, rather, fairly, quite, to, almost, hardly, fully, enough, so, altogether, no, pretty, any, partly. We have eaten enough. I am feeling much better. He is very great. Interrogative adverb. An adverb used to ask questions is known as an interrogative adverb. Where, when, why, how? When do you come? How long will you stay in Delhi? Where did you go yesterday? Relative adverb. An adverb used to relate two clauses or statements is known as a relative adverb. Where, when, and why? Example, I did not know where she had gone. Do you know when Madhvi came here? I don't know why she went to Hyderabad. A conjunctive adverb is used to join two clauses together, and some common conjunctive adverbs. Also, consequently, finally, furthermore, hence, however, incidentally, indeed, nevertheless, next, nonetheless, otherwise, still, then, therefore, and thus. Note, conjunctive adverb is not strong enough to join two independent clauses without the help of a semicolon. Example, the government has cut university budgets. Consequently, class sizes have been increased. Points to remember. Adverb of manner answers the question how. Adverb of place answers the question where. Adverb of time answers the question when. Adverb of frequency answers the question how often. Adverb of degree answers the question how much or in what degree or what extent. A simple adverb is used to modify the meaning of a verb, an adjective or an adverb. An interrogative adverb is used to ask questions. A relative and a conjunctive adverb is used to join two clauses or statements. The same words are sometimes used both as adjectives and adverbs. For example, adjectives, Raju is speaking in a loud voice. Here, loud adjective modifying the noun voice. And Madhvi never talks loud. So, it modifies the verb never talks loud. Kapil is a fast bowler, describing the bowler, fast. I cannot walk fast is modifying the verb walk fast and thus is an adverb. My sister will come to Vizag next week is an adjective, come is an adjective here, an adverb. I shall consider your case when I next come here. Adverbs which have two forms. Hard, diligently. We must work hard. Hardly, scarcely. I could hardly believe it. Near, opposite to far. Please come near. Nearly, almost. He is nearly defeated. Late, opposite to early. The train arrived late. Lately, recently. I have met Madhvi lately. Pretty, fairly. I am pretty sure of my success. Prettily, elegantly. Madhvi was prettily dressed. Clear, quit or leave. Keep clear of the entrance. Clearly, in a clear manner. You must speak clearly. thereby, hereafter, wherefore, therefrom, hereby, wherein, therein, herein, whereon, thereof, hereupon, whereof, thereon, herewith, thereto, hereto, therewith, henceforth, henceforward. Adverbs used in a pair. Sometimes two adverbs are used together. Again and again, repeatedly, by and by, before long, far and near, in all directions, far and wide, comprehensively, far and away, by a great deal, first and foremost, first of all, now and then, from time to time, occasionally, now and again, at intervals, sometimes, off and on, irregularly, intermediately, once and again, on more than one occasion. Position of adverbs. Adverbs of manner are commonly placed after the verb or object. Madhvi walks gracefully. Ramaji speaks politely. The doctor examined the patient carefully. Adverb of place and time may be placed after the verb or object. Example, she went there. I searched everywhere for my book. I saw a film yesterday. Adverbs of frequency and degree are generally placed between the subject and the verb, and if the verb contains several words, adverbs are placed after the first word. Example, my father never tells lies. I have never seen such a beautiful girl. I have often advised my sister to speak politely. Some adverbs are placed after the auxiliary verbs. You are always careless of your health. I am completely defeated in love. Adverbs must be placed before the auxiliaries, like have to and used to. I often have to attend yoga classes. He always used to sit in the garden. I never used to visit temples. If most adverbs are used, the order of adverbs is adverbs of manner, adverb of place, adverb of time. Example, I enjoyed well at the picnic yesterday. I met Madhvi at the theater yesterday evening. I expressed my feeling very clearly at the function yesterday. Formation of adverbs. Adverbs of manner are mainly formed by adding ly to the adjective. Clever, cleverly, wise, wisely, kind, kindly. When the adjective ends with y, preceded by a consonant y, is changed into I and ly is added. Adjective happy, happily, happily, ready, ready, will change to ready, heavy will change to heavily, heavily. When the adjective ends with le, e is changed into y. Single, singly, singly, double, doubly, doubly. Finally, e is retained with the following words. Adjective extreme, extremely, intensive, intensively, extensive, extensively, comprehensive, comprehensively. Exception, true, truly, due, duly, whole, wholly. For adjective ending with able or ible, the final e is dropped and y is added. Sensible, sensibly, e is taken out. Capable, capably, able, ably, considerable, considerably, probably, probably, possible, possibly. Kindly check the spellings all the time. Some adverbs are compounded with a noun or adjective. Example, sometimes, midday, yesterday, meantime, midnight, otherwise, meanwhile, midway. Some adverbs are compounded with a. A foot, a board, a broad, a new, a long, a loud, a sleep, a way, ahead, a life. Some adverbs are compounded with to and be. Today, behind, before, tonight, below, beneath, tomorrow, beyond, besides. Comparison of adverbs. Adverbs with single syllable form their comparative and superlative by adding er and est. Hard, harder, hardest. High, higher, highest. Early, earlier, earliest. Adverbs ending with ly form their comparatives and superlative by adding more and most. Swiftly, more swiftly, most swiftly. Skillfully, more skillfully, most skillfully. Quickly, more quickly, most quickly. Fortunately, more fortunately, most fortunately. Adverb of irregular comparison. So we have positive, comparative, and superlative. Badly, worse, worst. Good, better, best. Much, more, most. Little, less, least. Near, nearer, nearest. Next, far, farther, farthest. Further, furthest. Late, later, furthest, last.